Hi, this is Aileen from Materialise Belgium. In this tutorial video, we'll talk about the editing tools in Magics. The editing tools allow you to modify your parts for 3D printing. For example, if you'd like to reduce the weight of your parts, you can hollow them. If you need to cut your parts into smaller pieces, you can use the cut or punch option. If you'd like to make a printable solid out of a non-printable surface, the surface to solid tool will come in handy. If you need to identify your parts after printing, you can apply labels and label tags. If you'd like to get rid of problematic details on your part, you can apply a shrink wrap. And if you need to compensate for the shrinking after build, you can do a rescaling. Let's get started with the hollowing. I'm going to hide the two other parts, and I'm going to take a cross section on this part. This part looks completely red on the inside, and this is because this is a full solid part. With the hollow tool, you can remove the volume inside of this part to print lighter parts and prevent material waste. You only need to define a wall thickness and click OK. And now I have a nice hollow part that will be using less material and it will be a lighter part. Since this is a closed solid, it's a good idea to open perforations to remove the powder or resin that will get stuck inside. For this, we can use the perforator, locate a few perforation caps, if needed, add a small notch. By leaving the Keep Subtracted Parts option enabled, you can even print out your perforation caps. These caps will be printed with the rest of your part, and they can be attached back onto your part once your powder or resin has been removed from your part. For more details about the perforator, please watch our tutorial video on perforations. Sometimes, you might have to work with just surfaces. In this case, AutoFix can fix the errors, but it may not be able to achieve the right design. Instead of going back to the original CAD design, you can use the Surface to Solid tool. This tool will add an offset to the existing surface and create a solid that you can print. Sometimes, your part may be too big to fit into your platform. In this case, you can use the cutting tools to split your part into smaller pieces, which you can assemble after printing. You can apply direct polyline cuts. You only need to draw a polyline and click on apply. You can add teeth to these cut profiles. Let's draw another polyline, but this time we're also going to add teeth. Apply, OK, apply. Just like this. You can add lap joint cuts on sections. Apply. Like this. And you can even add connector pins and holes on a cut surface. just like this, holes on one side and pins on the other side. For more details on cutting, please watch our tutorial video on the cutting options in Magics. Let's go back a few steps again. Based on your 3D printing technology, your parts may be shrinking after print. Using the rescale function of Magics, you can rescale your parts to compensate for the shrinking. You will always see a preview. If you'd like to rescale your part based on a certain measurement, you need to first take a measurement. I'm going to measure a distance between a point and another point. For example, here to here. And then you can go to rescale, enable match measurement mode, select your measurement, and add a difference. As I click on apply, my part is going to be rescaled so that this measurement matches the desired value. Let's move to another part. Some parts that you would like to print may not be optimal for 3D printing. Namely, their inner details may be creating errors that make it very hard to fix these files. Like this. Here, shrink wrap can come to your aid. Shrink wrap will wrap a 2D layer around your part and is going to wrap it around your part. The inner details will be removed and your part will be free of errors. Now, this is a part that we can use. If you'd like to add labels on your parts, Magics gives you a wide range of options. You can apply rectangular labels, circular labels, you can control the label content. You can choose the font family, the font size, the alignment, the type of label, so whether your label is going to be engraved or raised. You can control how high or deep your label is going to be. And until you press apply as STL, your labels are going to remain in planning mode, which means that at any time, you can go back to your label and you can change the content of the label. And once you click on apply as STL, your label will be finalized. Let's also apply this label as STL. If you'd like to mass label parts, you can do so using the mass labeling option. In the mass labeling option, you can either use a CSV file with different columns that you can use as label content, or you can use a counter. For this example, I'm going to use a counter. And as label content, I'm going to add the part name dash the counter. I'm going to choose for 6 copies. I'm going to play with the alignment. And I'm going to click on apply as STL. And here I have 6 copies of my part with numberings starting from 1 to 2, to 3, to 4, to 5, and to 6. If you're not at liberty to place labels on your parts directly, you can choose to apply label tags. You can apply the tag anywhere you wish on your part. You can control how thin your breakpoint is going to be, so you can remove the tag easily afterwards. And you can click on apply. Now you can place your labels on this tag. Thank you for watching. And please make sure you check our other tutorial videos. For further questions about our software, please don't hesitate to contact the support line of your nearest Materialise office.